To use Imaginet Timesheet, simply open up a browser and enter in the URL to your timesheet server. In the username and password, type the credentials that you use to connect to Team Foundation server. I'm going to select the Fabricam Fiber Team project to browse to that project. The drop-down here will allow me to select a query. Let me select the All Bugs query. I'd like to see the Assign To field, so I'll hit Customize Columns, browse down to the Assign To, and hit Update to bring that column into my grid. I can sort the grid by any column by simply clicking in the column header. Clicking on the ID will open up the work item in Web Access. To enter time, I simply enter time in the grid according to which hours I've worked on which work items. And to save that to the timesheet database, I'll hit Save. If I want to complete this timesheet, I can submit the timesheet. I'll hit Submit to confirm. This now locks the timesheet to make it read-only. Reports can now differentiate between time I've simply saved and time I've actually submitted. I can reopen a locked timesheet by hitting Reopen and entering in a reason. Now I can edit this timesheet again. Timesheet also supports hierarchical queries. I'll change my query to the current sprint backlog. Here we can see that we have two title columns, similar to how TFS displays hierarchical queries in Excel. We can enter time against any of these work items. If I want to see all the work items that I've entered time for a particular period, I can select the This Week's Entries query in the query dropdown. To go back a week, I can either use the back button next to the calendar to move backwards a week, or I can use the calendar button to select a particular week to enter time against. Remember, once you've selected a date range, you'll need to select a query. To see some quick graphs about time entry for this week, hit the dashboard button. This will show me a gauge showing how many hours I've entered this week. I can see I've entered 6 hours. This will show me the last 5 work items that I've entered time against. The last 4 weeks graph will show a total of how many hours I've entered for the last 4 weeks. And finally, the This Week by Area chart shows hours pivoted by a particular field. We can change that field by hitting this gear icon and configure the pivot value. Let's change it to Assign to see hours against work item by Assign To. We can also change the graph type from bar to column to area chart simply by clicking one of the buttons on the top right of each chart.